online freedom of speech is at the heart of heated opposition to President Biden's pick to head the Federal Communications Commission. As CBN senior Washington correspondent Tara Merchant reports, Republicans say the nominee wants to silence conservative voices.
The White House calls Gigi Sohn a leading advocate for open and affordable communications networks that promote democracy. Conservative opposition, however, may delay acting on the nomination and keep the panel from having a Democrat majority. While the White House states Gigi has worked to defend and preserve the fundamental competition and innovation policies that have made broadband internet access more ubiquitous, competitive, affordable, open, and protective of user privacy, critics call President Biden's FCC nomination his most dangerous yet.
Her name is Gigi Sohn. How petrified should every American be about her nomination?
The FCC wields extensive authority over broadband providers, wireless companies, and broadcasters. Sohn, a communications attorney, is one of two progressive picks for the agency and a longtime supporter of net neutrality.
96% of residential high-speed broadband internet lines in this country are owned either by a cable company or a telephone company.
She previously served under Barack Obama as an architect of the commission's 2015 net neutrality order, gutted by a Republican-led FCC 2 years later.
Now, everybody likes net neutrality, but what they don't like is the FCC's ability to be a referee on the field and to make sure that networks are fast, fair, and open.
She's also hinted at deploying the agency's regulatory power to censor conservative media and revive a version of its mooted fairness doctrine. Republicans, including Senator Lindsey Graham, blasting the nomination on Twitter. GOP critics also point to numerous statements they say are red flags she'll censor conservative media, including this one. For all my concerns about Facebook, I believe that Fox News has had the most negative impact on our democracy. It's state-sponsored propaganda with few, if any, opposing viewpoints. And after Tribune Broadcasting abandoned its merger with right-leaning Sinclair Broadcast Group in 2018, she said, "Today is a good day for every American who believes that diversity of voices in the media is better for our democracy, and that the FCC should look at whether Sinclair is qualified to be a broadcast licensee at all."
She will go after the licenses of Fox News, of Sinclair, of anybody who disagrees with the Biden administration.
Brothers and sisters, persecution is coming. Believers in Jesus Christ, believe in the authority of the Bible. Get yourself spiritually prepared, because true Christians will be persecuted like no other time in history. This persecution will be based off of what the world perceives to be moral and right, and not what the Bible says. The sad thing is that many people who profess to be Christ followers will go the way of the world. These professing Christians are called lukewarm in the book of Revelation and are not saved. The world will persecute true Christians, and Scripture tells us the lukewarm Christians will persecute them as well, as we read in Matthew 24:9-10. Then they will deliver you up to tribulation and kill you, and you will be hated by all nations for my name's sake. And then many will be offended, will betray one another, and will hate one another. Many who professed faith in Jesus as the Messiah in easier times will deny him and cooperate in exposing those who are true believers. The external hatred from the world puts all true believers in Christ under pressure. This in turn produces internal hatred among the professing Christian community during the tribulation. When the pressure comes, those who are not genuine believers will do three things: fall away, deliver up one another, and hate one another. Matthew 24:9-10 lay out a future time of great persecution for true believers in Jesus. Many in the church will avoid this persecution by betraying fellow disciples in Christ to the persecutors. Persecution is coming. Brothers and sisters, put on the whole armor of God.